Hey guys, welcome back to Nergasha Disorder. Now, today I am going to be showing you guys how I remove my makeup. Now, I don't have a crazy look on today. I pretty much just have like my eyebrows done a little bit. I have some eyeliner, a little bit of eyeshadow. I have a little bit of like blush and bronzer on. Of course, I have highlight and my lipstick. Now, even if I have like a regular day look, this is what I also do for my night look. So if you guys want to see how I get all this off, kind of keep my skin like healthy, stay tuned. All right, so let's get started. Now with my hair being down right now, I'm actually kind of liking it. I got this tip. I do have curly hair and it's only gotten curly recently because one of my friends told me that I should stop using conditioner. Now, I use whatever shampoo I want to use, Pantene Pro-V, Dove, all the way to like Tresemme to Suave. Like, I use whatever, but I just don't use conditioner, and so far my curls have been really good. So, step one to every makeup removal, I gotta put my hair up. Alright, step one complete. Now, my bangs like to stay there and I don't want to look too crazy, so we'll just keep it like that. So, I'm wearing lashes right now, and all I do with my lashes is I just take them off. Like, nothing special. I don't put too much crazy glue on it. That's one. And that's two. Yeah, guys, I know if you guys are watching this, taking eyelashes off is not the hottest thing, but this is the things we do, and now my eyes look really crazy. So we are going to take some Clinique. This is the Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm. Now this is awesome. What it really does is that it's just a little balm like that. I don't know if you guys can see it. And all you do is you just take a little bit of it. So I actually have an older one here that I'm about to finish. So just take a little bit off of it. And it literally looks like that. Like, it looks a little weird, but it pretty much kind of like melts into your skin. So it went from white to kind of like nothing now. So put that there. I have, like, if I have a lot of eye makeup, I start with my eyes and all you do is just kind of rub it off. I'm still wearing my contacts and it hasn't ever caused me problems. So here I am. I kind of save my lips for last because it gets all over the place. So with my lashes, I'm actually really careful. I've been trying to take care of my lashes recently because so far with this balm, it's actually really nice. Oh my gosh, I know I look horrible right now. But as you guys could tell, like, all that like eyeliner's coming off. It's not like pulling at the skin. So it's kind of like you're giving yourself a face massage. I mean, you don't want to because it's like makeup, but yeah. So here's the bad part. I usually just try to take that off so it just doing my lips too bad. Yuck. And now we wash our face. If anything, I've been using this brand. It's from Korea. And it's actually pretty good. I can't even pronounce what it is, but it's a deep cleaning foaming cleanser. And it's awesome. I just kind of use like a quarter size of it. Like that. And here we go. I don't use any scrubs or anything like that. Like, people have all these crazy like things that help it foam, but I just kind of use my fingers and I kind of like massage. I try not to pull my skin down because gravity pulls it down. So I tend to try to go, don't forget your neck, guys. Like, ew. Boom. Now wash your face. All right, guys, now when I pat my face dry, all I do is just use a towel and I just kind of dab my face. You don't want to do any like dragging or pulling or anything like that, because your face pretty much has a lot of elasticity in it. And if you think about it, it's kind of like a rubber band. The more you pull on it, the more you tug on it and everything like that, your rubber band or the elasticity starts to wear out. So when I just pat my face dry, I literally just pat it and it's literally the same thing. So make sure you get everything and your face is pretty, to me, my face is pretty much clean. I went to Clinique and I got these, and they are pretty much called Clinique IDs, dramatically different hydrating jelly. Now I think with the orange one here is for tired skin. Oh, if it wants to focus, maybe not. So this one is for tired skin, orange, and purple is supposed to be for fine line and wrinkles. Now the lady who told who I bought this from, she pretty much said you don't put both of them at once, but this is like a jelly and it's so good, it like absorbs into the skin, because I tried it on my arm and it was amazing. But she pretty much told us that you either choose one or the other. So right now I'm not really worried about like wrinkles. Today I actually been feeling kind of sick, so I think I'm gonna try this orange one, the one that's for a tired skin. So I literally just got this, so it's probably gonna be a couple pumps. So I think we're just gonna use like one pump. Yeah, we'll just use one pump, maybe. Okay, just rub that all over the skin. Actually, we're gonna do two pumps, because yeah, that should be good. It doesn't smell like anything, guys, like at all. We'll just do that. Oh, but the thing is that what's nice about it is that it doesn't feel that it's like oily or it's clogging my pores. Like it actually feels like it hydrated my skin really well. Oh, all hydrated. Now, after all that's done, it feels like it's been soaked into my skin a little bit. It's not wet, but it feels really nice. Like it feels like my skin is elastic again. Like it feels a little tight, but it's nice. It's not sticky, but it feels like my skin likes it. So now I'm gonna go in with the Clinique Moisture Surge 72 hour auto replenishing hydrator. Like there it is. If you can't see it, I'll post up a picture. But yeah, apparently it's good for 72 hours. I haven't tried it yet. This is actually my sister's and I'm trying it out. So I'm just gonna take a little bit with the back of my nail. And then we're just gonna put this on. I always try to focus on like my eyes, because I've been really bad with my eyes recently. I've been pulling at it. I've been not nice. I've been squinting a lot recently. So we are definitely gonna make sure everything is good. Ooh, that feels really nice. So when I put lotion on, even if it's like sunscreen or anything like that, I always pull my face up. So you'll see me do that a lot, because gravity's already pulling your face down. You don't want to have gravity pull your face down. You kind of want to help get that lift. So and that feels good. Our next step is to take the All About Eyes Reduces Circles Puffs, and yeah, I guess that's all it does. It's just like the small little tester, but it'll last you a while. So I just take a little, put some just on the side there, some on the side here, and just rub it on like the corner of your eyes, underneath. Oops, I forgot to turn my phone off, my bad. Like I said, rub, put it underneath your eyes. And that feels really nice. So like I said, a little goes a long way. So my last step is that I kind of go in with the Lush Mint Juleps Lip Scrub. I love lip scrubs. I feel like I have okay lips, like decent sized lips. Like I don't think I need fillers or anything, but like I said, I feel like I'm kind of getting sick, so my lips get dehydrated a lot. What I like about this is that it's organic. So this is by Lush. Everything there is organic, like it's awesome. They're like cruelty free, they're good for the environment. And if I'm wrong, my bad guys, leave me a comment. Like I said, I apologize. But this one is so good. It smells amazing. It's nice, refreshing. And what it is that it's pretty much just like sugar, and I don't know what else they put in here, but what I do is that I take a little bit of it and I just kind of put it on my lips. Now what's cool about this too is that you can put it on your lips, scrub, and you can actually like lick it off. I mean, if you're all up for it, go for it. But for me, I feel like it's kind of weird, especially if I have like leftover lipstick. But yeah, you can actually eat this. It's literally sugar, maybe like some oil. Maybe, okay, let's see. It's got caster sugar, organic jojoba oil, vanilla extract, tangeets oil. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Peppermint oil. Pretty much like anything that you can eat, I'm pretty sure, because I've seen everyone eat this. Even the Lush representative said it's awesome. So let's just get to it. I kind of go windshield wiper wipes, I kind of go circles, kind of get everything to get all those dead cells off. All right, now, like I said, you can lick this stuff off. It's actually pretty good. But all I do is that I just get a little bit of water, kind of dab it on my lips. Take that same towel I use to wash my face, because I'm just going to throw this in the laundry anyway. And I kind of just wipe off the excess. And like I said, I was wearing, the lipstick I was wearing was by Fenty. It's called Uncensored. That's the one where the red looks good on everybody. And it, like, everything just literally came off. Like, all the residual like lipstick is off. Ew, I know it's disgusting, but it comes off the towel too, so no worries. Now after you exfoliate, you always, oh my gosh, sorry guys, after you exfoliate, you know you want to put a lip balm on. So the lip balm I got is called Whipstick, and yes, it's also from Lush. It's awesome, I love it. And it's rich, silky, and buttery, like hot chocolate on winter days. So that's all it looks like. And I just put a little bit on. Kind of coat to moisturize. And that's it. That's literally all I do to keep my skin. Hopefully my little routine helps. Sometimes I'll do masks, you know, those little cool masks or everything like that. But I kind of just wanted to show you guys how I take my makeup off. I don't have anything, my face is nice and clean. It feels so good right now. I might actually stick with this Clinique ID, and I'll let you guys know how it works. I've only used it, like, I haven't really used it a lot. I've used it before and it actually worked, but I kind of stopped. And now that I'm getting older, yes I am, I know. Now that I'm getting older, I'm just trying to take care of my skin. So I'll list all the pictures, all the items that, all the products that I use, and you guys let me know how you guys feel about it. Let me know about your comments, concerns, whether or not they're good or bad. Drop me a comment down below, I appreciate it. And that's pretty much it for the day. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you guys know when I post up a new video, and I'll catch you guys next time. Love you.